the Pittsburgh Penguins are Stanley Cup champions 2009.
All right, we've gained exclusive access to the Pens video room to watch a game that these two gentlemen haven't watched before. Max Talbot and Tyler Kennedy, Stanley Cup champions 2009.
What's up?
We're gonna get through the whole game, not just the goals that Max scored that he watches on YouTube or whatever all the time,
Every night.
I kind of feel like I'm a part of it, but we all know I wasn't. There is something kind of cool about when you win together, right?
Yeah. Well, yeah. We're gonna look at the game and you're part of that cup. And you know, because we all grew up together in a way, you know, from Wilkes-Barre to, that's where we created that bond that got us to win in 2009, yes, but it started in 2005. Obviously, we, you know, added some part and got rid of bad apples, but, you know, we still, you were kind of part of that. It was great.
Yeah. I think back on that as my best time in hockey, honestly.
For sure.
And, you know, my heart was broken when I got traded, just because I knew we were going to be good, but because like some of my closest buddies still to this day, and that's where it all started. So you're right. It was a process that built up.
Yeah. And when it happens, Colby, like when you're in the midst of it, you don't really realize it. You never know when is the best time of your life.
Yeah.
You know, you never really know. And talking to guys like, you know, Flower, Sid, Letang, and they all say it's probably the best time.
Yeah, I've talked to Sid about that too. He's like, man, that was the best. Yeah. It was a unique team and a unique situation. Now, let me tee up this, right? So like 08, I'm traded. You guys stormed to the final. Heartbreaking loss to the same team that you guys faced again. What are the odds of that?
Well, you know, the year before, they just outsmarted us, outplayed us. You know, they just passed around us.
They're the Detroit Red Wings, man.
Yeah, like, it was crazy. As a younger guy, you try to run Lindstrom through the wall, and he'd do the little back pass.
Yeah.
And you know they're going the other way, and you're just like, wow, what a play.
Yeah.
You know, it was.
It was like a father son game.
Seriously,
that's what it was. Yeah. It was like kids working really hard, and the dad's just like,
yeah.
We won the conference final against Carolina in 4 in 09. So a pretty confident team, and I remember Detroit playing Chicago in their conference final and cheering for Detroit because I wanted to play them again and I wanted
really?
To. Oh, yeah, I remember just wanting
you wanted
Detroit
another
again.
Shot at them.
Yeah.
If you're a hockey fan for that kind of theater to see two teams, the young kids that lost, and then they get another crack at it the next year, it's kind of a perfect setup for another final. And
even though it was like crazy, this is Sid being Sid. So we all used to say at the MGM, remember that?
Yeah.
And then I don't think we ever won, right? We only won game 7 in Detroit. So we are always staying at the MGM. And Sid, I think, said, hey, we have to change this up. We haven't won in Detroit. So we end up going to like a hotel, a little like what, 20 minutes outside Detroit?
Like a La Quinta Highway Hotel?
Yeah, yeah. We lost. Yeah, we got
by
like,
the hour.
Yeah, yeah, seriously.
Let's really lost. Change it up.
Bring your sheets.
Yeah. But we end up losing game 5. And I remember we came back, obviously won in game 6.
And we got smoked in game 5, 5-0.
Yeah, we got smoked. And then we came back, we won game 6. And I remember there was that big conversation, like, where are we going to stay? And I remember a lot of the guys were like, enough of this. We're going back to MGM, and we're going to do it the right way.
Yeah.
Right? And I was like, you know, just little things. You're like, wow, that screw everything. We're going there, and we're going to prove that we're the better team.
That's really inside the mind of the beast of like whatever it takes to win, isn't it?
That's true.
Oh, it was
change the hotel, like get anything, everything different, sleep in your bed upside down.
Yeah. You heard Flower too at MGM the night before that game where, you know, you couldn't sleep. The day of the game, in pregame nap, you couldn't sleep, they were making noise. And then he went, it's game 7.
Yeah.
And right before this game, and he puts a leaner, a garbage can full of water on the side of the door that the people were making noise. And he knocked and he just left. And then they opened the door.
Like during the afternoon?
During the afternoon before game 7.
Pre-game nap, Fleury did a leaner on a guy's door. Who does that?
Flower.
Max, do you remember when they used to have on our dressing room of the visitors, it said Red Wings and Flower did the whole chicken wings. Remember he taped it all out and he put chicken wings instead of Red Wings? Like it was just him being Flower. And this is like
this is the starting goaltender for the Penguins in the Stanley Cup playoffs.
But it just like
he's
relaxed.
The best.
Oh, yeah.
So you guys wanna watch the game?
Let's do it.
I hope I play well.
You can't have 106 bad games in a row, TK.
Yes.
You're due.
Yeah, yeah.
Look at their lineup.
Yeah. You nervous?
Yeah, I'm like, watching. I'm like, I hope
we... What a save. You saw that save from Flower there? Like, that's when I knew, okay, we're good. Oh, you got to win that battle, TK. What are you doing?
Wait. Do you see that, though?
Why don't you finish him?
Because... Look at me. Look at where I'm all
over.
You're
all over TK.
Yeah. All over.
Now you did a switch in with Stalzy. Good job. Good switch. Good communication.
Like, they were so smart. And I was...
Yeah, they were. Intimidating.
Yeah. And, like, you know, you couldn't get a penalty because they were, like, it's automatic goal, you know?
Oh, my God. You were nervous, eh?
I really was nervous. Like, I'm not joking. I was nervous. I told him, hey, chip it in the corner. I don't want to handle this thing. Just put it in the corner.
This is your second year, TK. Stalzy's also, right? This is his second, third year? Pretty amazing the impact he had on games.
Oh, my God.
At 21.
Just
third
eats
line,
up
just monster, throws guys around.
Never tired, so good. Sleeps all
that,
day.
That third line was just so good.
Oh, Orps. That guy actually hit Orps and took the puck from him. I was so scared of Orps at every training camp.
Oh, I watched the shift online recently. Like the,
it's like boom, boom, boom.
I think it took us like a half a period to actually settle in.
That's true.
Like, again, I know we had Sid and Crosby.
But yeah, both of them, Sid and Crosby.
Sorry, Sid and Malkin.
We should get
we both had both of them.
You get both those guys.
But when you look
team,
across and you see Datsyuk and Zetterberg, like they were like,
I know.
They were pretty close to those guys.
And they played together.
Yeah, and they
were
like.
That's one thing too, you know, Sid and Gino were in two lines separate. But Datsyuk, Zetterberg, you get against that line, you're like, what do we do?
You guys get getting scrambly in the own end, but I don't blame you with this team because they swirl around and
they're moving.
They're moving like mad. Like they kind of like the way the game is now. They started doing that.
Yeah.
Like they kind of started changing the game a little bit.
Watch Evgeny Malkin. Watch what he does.
Of course, Gino. Like let's talk about Gino, MVP.
To me, Gino, when he's really at the top of his game, is the best player I've ever played with. The most dominant player I've ever played. For one game, you give me Gino at his best, you know?
Because he's such a freak.
Against Carolina, he was man versus child. In the conference final, he was man versus child. Like, we couldn't touch him. Yeah. He scored a hat trick that one game. He was just too strong, too good, too confident.
Yeah.
Like,
here we go. TK, your line gets buzzing here. Yeah. Come on.
Like, I love when, you know, now I look back, I love when I take three hard strides and try to put them through the wall, and they still have the puck. Like,
It's a thought that counts, TK.
Yeah. You got to make them pay.
You're showing an intensity.
Oh, no way.
Wow.
This is
awesome. He was there.
Did you know that?
No.
Muhammad Ali at the game.
I remember seeing Kid Rock, too.
You and Malkin always switch off on face-offs, or how'd you play that?
I would be the center in D zone sometimes. Yeah. Like, I would go and I would, like,
here he goes. Here he's got a touch. Oh, great
smart
thinking.
Play, yeah.
Oh, that's all I can
do.
And he beats him. That's the second time you've got in front of guys and got first to puck.
My legs were so light.
You know why?
Light.
You're not scared. That's why.
My legs were so light.
They are always. Your legs are always light.
Yeah, but that game, like, I felt like I.
Oh, look at that little play by Gucci.
Hey, like, we talk about that. That's what they used to do to us. Take the hit, you know,
and reverse it,
you know?
That's what I want to teach my 12-year-olds.
Yeah.
Yeah,
because it's so easy the way that this was.
Way.
This
and
is
no
the best
one stops,
way.
Stops, right? They just
no. You're always moving.
The net.
It's tough to forecheck.
Yeah,
because you need three guys
you
to
need
be.
Three guys you need three guys to collapse on it, or else you always have an out.
Like look at that! Like look at
look at that pass
cross ice with that's a guy on his back.
Eats, look at Eatsy down there. I like Eatsy. He's a great teammate.
Yeah,
that Cleary was a good player too.
Yeah, he was.
Yes. You know,
really good. Oh, Billy G. See a Datsyuk. Billy's huge.
And he used to have his sticks. Heavy. It'd grow up. It'd go an inch up every period because he was getting little
back. His
back is sore. Yeah, he'd go. It'd be like, oh, that's my third period sticker. We're like, what? Yeah, it's just a little longer, you know.
How do you do that?
What about Scuds too, eh?
Yeah.
Scuds, see how great he was.
The piece.
Yeah, the piece.
The piece.
Sure. That's his name. That was it. What game did he made all these stops in the crease? Was it game six?
I think.
Oh, Cookie.
Cookie.
That's what he does. Old.
Hey, he hit hard, though. Eh?
Oh, my God.
He was like a strong one.
He's
like,
a block.
Yeah, he's built like a cigarette machine. He's a tank, you know?
Yeah. He's thick.
But, like, he had to know when he's on the ice. That was the beauty of him, right? Like,
he created so much room.
And we played with him, you know, very fortunate, obviously, because when I went to Colorado after later in my career, it was in Minnesota.
Yeah.
And playing against him is just... the worst, right? Because Oh my God!
Put that
right there.
Shoot it!
Come on!
Hit him!
Look at me.
That was nice. Stop at the net, though.
Yeah.
He's so hyped up. He's got his
I'm still skating.
That's a good shift right there. That's like three chances in a row. Oh, third line.
Look at this move.
Big hit in the D zone.
I love this move, though.
That's a nice move.
Like the push and shoot.
Oh!
Remember Gaunch's skates? They were all like falling apart.
Gaunch is the kind of guy that would get a new pair of skates, I feel, in Game 7 Stanley Cup playoffs, Stanley Cup final, and like take them out of the box and put them on and go out for warm-ups, and we'd all be like, why is he wearing
these? And it'd be like kind of just like
I was always amazed. He'd be like flexing forward. And like gliding. He never picked his feet up when he skated. He just like little shuffle pushes, you know?
Yes.
But we'd be so like, calm. Why is he wearing new skates? Like, this is a
sure
big
you
game.
Do this, Gaunch?
That was the best player to stand in front of that when he would shoot.
Oh.
Because you knew he was not going to hit you.
Who was the worst player?
Oh my God, I can't say. But I have a lot of names that comes to my mind.
Yeah, everyone is going high and hard.
Yeah.
I remember me and Stahl used to, he'd give it to me, TK. I'm going to stand in front. You can't go bar down, bud. You haven't hit the net yet today.
Man, Gino looks so young. Hey, look at that.
Someone should have told him what his visor. Like, that's a tough visor.
I'll never forget for Christmas for, like, a gag gift. Because Gaunch had the big visor, too.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I got him a jug of windshield washer fluid.
No, you didn't. Oh, this is great.
Did he laugh or
he didn't like... get it.
He just put it in his car. Oh, thank you.
Oh, look, we're just waiting them out.
Oh, yeah, you guys got the trap set up.
Before me.
Oh!
That was scary.
Flower handled it, gave Hossa a little stick as he caught it, too.
Flower still has the fastest glove ever.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like, he'd give it to you in practice and it'd be gone in the set, you know what I mean? And you'd try to
that's a tricky little one there. Yeah.
They used to always do that, remember, though? They'd always flip it in and they'd always do this. Yeah.
Franzen.
Lindstrom would do that all the time.
The mule.
Franzen was so good. He was so tough to box out, like, so big.
He's so huge, hey?
It's crazy.
Sick hands.
Oh my God! Do you remember
Let's rewind that.
I do
I was going to say, I bet you would be the one, but I don't remember that.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
That would have been I think it would have been a different game.
You'd have been on a stretcher.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
You were like...
Well, maybe a different game, you're right?
It would be 2-0. He hit to hurt. Like, he hit to put you in the hospital. Yeah, yeah.
When I kind of start to look...
He's skating out of the zone when he
looks. You see, I have the right habit, like, here, like, kind of
there,
like...
you took a side peek.
Not enough.
Remember the year before? He caught Malone, Bugsy. And I remember Bugsy coming to the... Remember he coming to the bench? And his nose is over here. Remember his nose is over here, blood everywhere.
Yeah, he hits like a truck.
Remember Sid skates with the pumps?
Yeah, the pump. Yeah.
Ghost.
Oh, what a great play! God. Oh, my God!
Look at Gaunch's heart rate's just like 90 right now. He's like, all right, give it to me.
And I remember some...
Look at this. Look how old school this is still, though. Like, Gaunch, Tanger, two D-men power play.
Yeah.
Like, that's how old's Tanger DP here?
He's a year younger than me. He's 20.
20 on the power play in the play. Like, I mean...
In Game 7.
He was so good.
Remember, he stayed after practice and just skate. He was just...
He could skate forever and hard.
Yeah,
isn't that crazy? Two D-men on the peeps?
That's when you realize the game is changing in a way where now you go 5-4.
You know, I would try that before I went 2D.
Yeah. Well, it depends who your D's are. Back in 2009, you know, not a lot of team, I'm sure, had like 7 face-off plays every dot. You know, we would have so many options, and it was... We were all on the same page, right? Scudsy.
He's all right. Scudsy's so strong.
There's Cookie
cleaning up. Well, everyone wants a call.
Oh, go.
You guys got to get going on this. On the
I see you're going to do this one here.
Yeah, give him a little lesson.
It's crazy how tight it is. Like, nothing off the rush. It's all like this is like a hard working period, really, by both teams. It's tight.
But the wind has changed now, you know? Like, we're... At least we're tilting the ice a little bit more than the start. TK was right. You know, the start of the game for the first 7 minutes, we're nowhere.
What was the building? What did it feel like? Because they got good hockey fans, right? Like,
it was loud, but we still had, you know what? Yeah. I'd say 5%, 10% of
Pens fans.
Yeah.
And you know, you notice that? Like, yeah. You can see that? Yeah.
When you scored, you see them stand up, yeah. Right? That's when you're like, okay, we got a little bit of people here, but they were loud. It was a good building. Like with the squid on the ice and
it was like the old Melon, you know.
Yeah, I felt
like it had that old like history and that feel.
Smell like beer and wings and pizza.
Sid's got the same gloves,
just different colors.
We took at Sid's gloves. We looked at Sid's gloves. We're like, Sid, they're still leather, aren't they heavy? Like leather.
He likes
gloves.
The leather.
Protect his elbow.
Yeah, I know. He doesn't wear elbow pads. He just wears his gloves. Oh, there's the TK patented.
You know what?
Turn and fire.
A good game, TK.
Actually,
yeah.
I think TK, you're like everything you did is an energy guy. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like that's what you did. Like you shot, like energy shot, energy pass, energy chip, energy skating, energy physical.
Not too much thinking, like, just go.
Yeah, but it's like hard to do that every game, you know, or be that guy. Like not a lot of guys can do that. Like I watched a game today. I'm like, why can't this guy do that? Why can't he be that guy? They don't know. When you see teams that are like defined, like your guys' group, and
who's that coming down?
Hold up.
What am I doing there?
Well, Gino got knocked down. He's probably supposed to be there.
Yeah. Oh, that's true.
Oh, you're the one.
Oh my God. That was a poke check.
He's the best at that, maybe of any goalie in the league right now, but at least through his era. Like, who is better at with the poke check or like the acrobatic stuff than him?
Nobody.
Oh, look at that little touch pass to his defense part. Gonch is so good, hey?
It's amazing.
Yeah. He played like the other team.
Yeah, I know. You've been unreal in Detroit.
Yeah, that's true.
How good would he have been on Detroit?
Oh, my God.
There's Flower. I know Flower's like smothering pucks.
Yeah.
Slowing down the tempo.
Slowing down the tempo. Yeah. Anytime he can get a little freeze, he catches it.
Oh.
Oh, that was a nice save.
Oh, my God. He went poke check again.
Yeah.
And then flash of leather.
And Fleury
does so much in practice.
Yeah, right? Like for people at home, like Flower, every time that he brings the stick out.
Yeah, it's like a cobra.
Yeah, but he says it. He said, poke check.
Yeah.
He will say it out loud at the same time.
I hate it when you come down on him. You do it in a game too. He would bring his hand up his blocker hand off his stick so you could see it's like he's getting ready to maybe set the poke check. Then he would shake it. Then he'll pull it back. And he'll like do that in a game when you... He like knows when you take a quick look at him, he'll do something, you know?
Yeah.
I gotta send that clip to Stalzi. Cross ice in the air.
It's a bad turnover, huh?
Yeah, not against them. We need to get out of this period. We're just chucking pucks.
Oh. Is that it? Is this the first period's over? What are we doing?
Yeah, we're done.
Oh, that was it?
Yeah, that was the first.
Did you guys sit in the same spots in the dressing room every game you guys went there?
Oh!
You just missed a goal.
Look at he's so surprised.
You just missed a goal. I can't believe you didn't know when was the goal.
I didn't see it coming.
Yeah.
Look at the eyes. Max, were you thinking or you just did it?
I
just rolled the hands over back 5-hole.
Yeah,
and opened them up a bit.
I like to shoot 5-hole quite a bit, and I just by my fake, I knew it was kind of open, so I faked and moved left and opened them up.
Cities do all. Remember, you used to screw with Flower all the time.
Yeah,
right?
You'd always go like this though.
That goal meant so much
because it just kind of came out of nowhere, right? One mistake. That's kind of how it is, right?
Yeah.
You guys feel that? It was like kind of one mistake.
Oh, it was one good shift. Like you know, we came out with a momentum.
Yeah.
One good shift, and then we get on the ice and score.
Now you got control of the game.
Yeah.
But again, I think that gave us a little bit more hope, you know, that goal. You
For
know,
sure.
Like we could, like, relax
I don't
a little
think we
bit.
Ever had the lead in Detroit. You know, like, in 2 years in the finals. I don't think we really, maybe one game.
After that goal, I don't think we've touched the puck too much. Like, they're coming hard right now.
Oh, that's more in the third. In the third, we have one shot on that. Oh, that's where Sid gets
what
hurt.
What happened there? Did he hyperextend his knee a little bit?
No,
or?
I think it was like a Charlie Horse. It was the pressure against the wall.
Oh, he crunched
him. Yeah, he crunched it.
I remember saying on the bench going, you're all right. You're all right.
Yeah, you'll be fine.
He's gone.
Oh, he's getting a water.
Oh, he's limping.
It's crazy how he was not able to finish this game. It's more than half a game, right? It changed the lines. See?
Oh, yeah.
It's kind of just crushed the knee.
Oh, look at his face.
He's hurt. TK is like, oh shit.
Oh, does that mean I gotta play more?
Yeah.
But I think when Sid got hurt, it screwed everything up because then it screwed the rotation. Because I was so used to playing with Stahl and Cook.
For sure.
As soon as you threw something out there, I was like, you know, especially for me,
yeah.
I had to stay on the right wing because that's I was so just comfortable there. As soon as I went to the left wing, I was lost out
there. Oh, you see, now Stahl is with Billy and Kunitz.
Now we're just trying to hang on.
Oh. Skills. I love skills. That guy's head in the little glass there, though.
Oh, like that was them.
That was a penalty. Yeah, but
that was a penalty.
That maybe not game seven, you know, or whatever in playoffs. But
that was an interference.
Yeah,
penalty.
That was interference.
That's what Skillsy does.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, good stick right there by Cooney. Look how wide open I am, Max. FYI.
What a shot!
I should have given it. Should have given it to TK.
What a snap.
He let you shoot it, though. You walked, that was a breakaway. Yeah. I mean.
Yeah, he gave me room.
I think they were on a change, it looked like, kind of, and it kind of sprung loose.
Well, I'm supporting what from the right here? Wing. I'm not even supporting from a center standpoint. I'm supporting more as a slash, right?
Yeah, you're slashing across that little poke.
So that was a great poke.
You're just hunting.
Where's it touch?
Oh, they changed, and so look this guy's late.
And look at Osgood's positioning, too. The hole is there the whole time.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Oh yeah, that's
like
big
that
time.
Was a snap. Like that was a snipe.
And he even moved towards. It looked like he tried to give it to you.
This angle's awesome.
Look at the glove. Side.
Oh ooh, my God!
I know. He's not playing his angle right. Maybe he's giving it to me to give it
hey,
away.
Hey, were you just like?
Yeah. Oh yeah. I thought he was doing Brodeur. Brodeur would do that.
Yeah,
sometimes.
He'd come over and then take it away, exactly. And then you look like an idiot. You know?
I thought he was doing that. So I'm like, but still try it, right?
Hey, what about the celly? What's the? Well, that was.
That's the only time in my life
like
I celly.
Praying. You're
that's
like,
the I never did another celly in my life.
It was like a soccer player celly, kind of, knowing to slide on their knees.
Maybe. And I don't know why I did that.
I like that
all the
celly
prayers
too.
From the night before were coming true. You're like,
but it's crazy because usually I would always go just like this when I scored because I was kind of surprised.
Yeah, you always did this little thing.
Yeah, I was surprised.
But your legs gave out.
Maybe.
Do you like Dan as a coach?
Moments.
Yeah.
I thought Dan was a phenomenal coach.
There's not a chance we win without Tyrion, you know, like in a way where he got us there. In a way, we came so close too, you know, he got us there. And then his firing happened at the right time. Right. And we needed the change. We need a new emotion.
Yeah.
He and told you what you were, right? Like he was very honest. Like, hey, this is how you're going to stay in the league, you know?
Yeah.
And then I think Balsman was like, this is how you're going to be successful in the league, you know?
Yeah, but he brought looseness and fun and emotion with Billy G, and it was just like more like, okay, let's just go back and play.
Yeah.
Remember he'd pour water and pregame skates over his head?
Damn. Oh, it would do a bunch of crazy
stuff.
But
that was like...
Yeah, he was funny as hell.
Who did, Bosma was?
Oh, yeah. Bosma would be so funny and loose. He looks very, like, game-faced, but then he would do a bunch of, like, stuff to make us laugh. And,
he knew how to read a room, that's for sure.
What round pick were you?
Eighth round.
Eighth round pick. Look at this. I mean, and then you think even forward in Penguins history, I guess. Hornquist scored the game-winning goal on the one. It wasn't game seven, mind you, but he was like the last pick in the draft.
Yeah.
So it's like kind of cool, like these guys. This is like what you know about, the guy
that's
like...
Look at his team, Datsuk. Datsuk was a seventh rounder, I think.
Zetterberg late.
Look at Lidstrom, that's...
Did he knock that down under midair?
Yes.
That was his move.
Oh my God, it's so frustrating.
You can't even dump pucks on Lidstrom.
No. Very bad read for me. TK is like, can I get Stahl back at center?
Just let me know when there's 2 minutes left in the game.
Oh,
don't
like
throw
that,
it
TK.
Back. Yeah.
Can't do that.
I might have sat a little bit after that one.
No, you didn't.
There's the bench. You guys are sitting beside each other. Yeah. That was nice.
Turn the puck over, TK.
Yeah. Is there any talking on the bench, really, or is it just like...
It's focused.
Super focused.
Yeah.
Like...
Quiet, we got this, boys.
Like every time they've showed your bench, everyone's just sitting there watching, you know?
Yeah.
There's no rah-rah anything. It's just.
And Dan would bring this, Dan Balsma would bring this kind of. He was calm behind the bench.
This is just.
That is
oh my
bad.
God. Did you see that? Cleary jumped in the air and then landed with a skate and flower and like drop kicked him.
That's bad support by a centerman, though. That was me.
Well, started the game as a winger. Okay, Scudsy rim, hits a thing.
Oh,
I mean, great little bump to Zetterberg. That was huge. You guys are running around right now. Fleury looks confident, though. Fleury looks confident. Uh-oh.
Oh.
He thinks he
he has it.
I forgot about that one. Imagine how Sid feels in the room. You know what I mean? Like, that's, I always wonder, like, what is he doing now? Like,
is he on a training table just watching a TV and, like, freaking out?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Oh, we're like, okay, thank God. Let's go back to the room.
Oh, here we go. The Talbot Pierre Maguire interview. Two Pittsburgh legends talking right now.
Yeah, that's a tight, thick beard.
No white, huh?
No.
No white.
Once you have a kid, it starts going white.
What's going on in the room? Are you guys getting info on Sid at this point a little bit?
Is he... Well, we're asking, like, any... He's in a training room with ice on him.
What's it like watching this?
I feel like I'm enjoying it, but I'm not enjoying it, right? Like, I like, oh, this is so awesome.
Is it
awesome.
Stressful?
Yeah, it's stressful. I'm like, I wish I could just, like, sit back and relax. But I'm like, I'm still, like, on the edge of my seat. You know, and I think, again, I never really, after my career, I never really watched a full game of me playing, you know? And I think it obviously, you know, and you were saying, oh, like, look how much energy you bring. And I remember everyone saying, oh, you're like a little spark plug out there. But I was like, well, I thought I was more of a dangler, but, you know, but now I see it. And like now, you know, again, when you watch it, you realize what you bring to a team. I watch a thing that says, like, everyone watches more clips, no one watches full games. And it's the gray areas that you learn a lot about the game, you know?
Makes a lot of sense to get,
Yeah, you know, like, it's everyone watches little clips, all the highlight clips. But we were growing up, we'd watch full games, and, like, your dad would be like, wow, see that pass? See how he did this? Mm-hmm. You know, even now, watching Game 7, you can see just, like, the little plays that, like, wow.
Oh, shit, here we go. Datsuk's starting to...
Oh, my God.
That hit Skillsy.
Like, what a big save.
Like, don't those guys look so, like, just calm? Yeah, you know, they look, like, look at this.
Oh, Skillsy's down again.
No, oh, Skudzy. What a save. That was a long PK shift.
Ooh.
Yeah, that's what Fleury does. He'd love it. I think Gino had the shot on that. I think we had one shot on that in the third.
Yeah.
And I'm not sure. I think it's Gino. I got it.
Like,
there we go.
Orp, that was everything paid off for him there in the gym. That was it.
Yeah.
He was strong.
He was so strong.
Come on. We're getting tired here.
No, you guys are just...
Yeah.
Guys are grinding, getting it to the red, and then just, like, settling for that and just getting ready for the next wave, you know?
Yeah.
But it's under control right now. Like, it's nothing's easy for them here.
No. And they know they need to get two, right?
Yeah.
So...
Yeah.
If one, it would be, I don't know, might be a different story. You know, if they would have scored at the end of second.
Yeah. Good job, Feds. Finishing hits.
Follow it up. There you go. Here we go.
Is this you, Max?
Yeah.
Again, Max, like.
That's
he was feeling it. He was feeling it.
Yeah. I wanted it.
Talbot, you're all over this game. Not like in a lot of almost would have, could have.
Yeah.
Almost woulda, coulda, shouldas, even
though. Man, come on, man.
Yeah, my legs were. You could tell you were feeling it, you know?
Yeah, my legs were really under me.
You know when you score, your legs just on.
You feel great.
Yeah, you're just like,
I know.
If you haven't scored in a while, you're
here. He is.
Oh.
This is his first shift.
Oh, his own face off.
Look at his leg, it's straight. He can't even bend his leg.
What did they have on him in this? Was his leg all taped up? Like, what did he have? He hasn't moved. He hasn't. No, he can't skate. Look at him.
He's going to change quick.
Sid, you got to bend your leg. You know?
Is he skateboarding? He looks okay there.
Yeah. Imagine the adrenaline, you know, for him not to be able to play and then do a shift and then realize that, I'm not helping the team.
And he's crazy. Like, he's like so competitive.
How bad it is for, like,
he's
off
now. Yeah, he doesn't want to deal with it.
He was pretty good on the bench, so, like, guy. So, like, I remember him coming back and he could just stick there. And I'm like, Sid, I can't think right now.
Sid, come back. Come back, please.
Sid. You know what's funny? Like, their fans aren't going too crazy. You
I
know,
think that's tense.
You know, like, they're not on their feet. I think they understand there's two goals is.
Like, they look tired, though.
Yeah. You got to change. 8 minutes left.
I mean, this is just all heart. This is just all heart at this point, right?
Oh, just battling. I think that's when we get scored on. That shift.
Right here?
I'm not sure. Yeah, right here.
What happened there?
It's just, knuckle puck a little bit. to D to D.
No screen.
No screen.
He whiffed
what
it.
What a surprise shot.
Okay.
Though. Yeah. D to D from wall Wide. To wall, one timer. Like, who would ever think of one timer?
And now we're shitting our pants.
Yeah.
Now we're like, oh. Wow. So after this goal, I remember going to see Flower.
Yeah, what'd he say?
And I go to him, I'm like, dude, I still have the winning goal.
Yeah, I know. That's what you think, right?
Yeah,
I know.
I'm like, you just stop him now. It's in your hand. I kind of like put a little pressure on him.
Yeah.
Watch this, little chip.
Oh.
Look, I still chip.
TK.
Change.
TK, you're a shooter. Why are you passing?
I know. I think
it's the first pass I see you take on 2-1.
Ever.
Yeah. Ever.
We still haven't got the shot on net. You know,
we're hanging on.
You've had two 2-on-1s that didn't transpire.
Whoa. Kind of.
I got a turnover on a 3-on-1 for me.
Couldn't have been like panicking too much. You're okay with your game, kind of, right? Or no?
Yeah, but it's not the way to defend and the way to stop playing, right? Because there's a difference between, you know, being patient and being passive.
Yeah.
You know, you want to be patient but not passive.
Patiently aggressive. Yeah. Oh, here we go.
That's the shot.
Boom.
There we go.
That was it. Gino's the only guy up ice there at that time.
I got an assist by that shot.
You assisted on their only shot in the period. It's insane watching these net battles, like, or throw, like, wrestling with Holmstrom in there and trying to clear bodies and pucks firing in there.
Because you think about it, there's not one bigger stage in a way where you fight for your life. There's
everything.
This is cool now, like, watching, right? You see everyone standing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
For 3.5 minutes left, this is everything.
Look at Orbs. He's so scary.
Look at his eyes. Are just
He's so scary. He's so like, ooh.
That's crossbar. That was just shot with traffic, nothing from the outside.
Yeah.
That could have been.
That was
with 2 minutes and 10 seconds left.
Yeah. Everybody's life changes.
Guys are coming off. The other guy just saw some guys have their heads down.
Saw Babcock going to Osgood, no stay.
Yeah.
But as a fan, what a game.
Yeah.
You know, like.
Pittsburgh fan.
I think I'm done for shifts.
Let's just go.
Yeah, TK, you're going to have to take a seat here, bud. All right, boys, let's go.
That crossbar.
Look at that helmet.
Well, let's see what happened here. Through off Scudsy, did it hit Stalzy's jersey? Yeah. That may have just gone over if it didn't hit Stalzy's jersey.
Yeah, the sock there.
It hit his.
If the puck is just on the other edge, it
flips
look
down.
At this.
Oh, no.
Imagine Flowers' like reaction.
Well, he's looking. It comes through Scudsy on the other side, and then go through those two guys in front. Mm. It looked like it ticked his shoulder a bit, eh?
Yeah.
Fleury's had a hell of a game.
Yeah. Amazing.
One looks like he's 20, the other one looks like he's 40.
He's 55.
Yeah. Ozzy's like old, he's an old guy.
Look, I'm trying to get involved. I'm like, not a chance. I'm playing.
Billy knows his game's over.
Billy's
too.
Just like, oh my God. He's looking at the clock during the timeout, hoping it's going to keep ticking.
I remember hearing Duper like talking about this moment. It's like just the clock goes so slow.
Yeah.
You know, you're just focusing on it. You're like, come on, man.
You got all their big horses on the ice, empty net, Aussies out. 1:17 left.
Stalzy.
I mean, amazing, hey? Stalzy, yeah. Talbot, Ads.
I think we're finishing.
Let the horses go to work. Let the.
That's when I wanted it. You see, he's got an empty net. That was my hat trick.
Why didn't he bump it? It's hard to see because the fans are all standing, but that's perfect right there.
I'm right there. I'm past the red
line. That's the only time you guys had like a break in this period. Was that Scudsy?
That would have been a penalty.
Was that a ref that stopped the puck or what? Or a player?
I think he just chipped it up the wall.
Yeah, he chipped it up.
All he had to do was bump it to you.
And I called for it. I'm like, yeah.
Yeah, you were there. That was a hat trick. I mean, that's...
Come on, Adzi. Joking.
How much ice time did you end this game with?
I don't know.
20?
I feel like you've been on the ice a lot. You got ate up a lot of ice and you don't look tired at all. Like, you look like you have good energy.
Two goals does, eh?
Yeah. 32 seconds. What's a bench doing right now? Well, these guys are going to finish this off.
I think everyone's like looking up at the clock, but the clock...
No one's saying a thing.
Not a thing. And everyone can't believe how slow the clock's going.
Wow, Flower.
You wanted the goal.
What a game by Flower.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
off of Lidstrom. Face off here. Face off inside. They got all their. They look tired.
Yeah.
Like Brooksy, body language, facial expressions. You know.
Brooksy played some hard minutes. All day. Yeah. Like.
Yeah, Brooksy plays a hard defensive game.
Yeah, that like.
It's not easy.
It's going through your mind, TK.
Yeah.
Don't put me
on. Looks like you guys are all off. No one's saying anything, but you guys are all like on the edge of your seats. Oh. Yeah, this is everything.
I feel like I'm
starting
crying.
I feel like.
Should have blocked that.
This puck just kicks over to him.
What
a game by Flower.
Oh my God. That was unreal.
Amazing feeling, hey?
Oh.
I think they're surprised. They're like, what happened there? How did we lose that one?
Yeah.
You know, because they were so confident.
Yeah, especially in the third, how hard they pushed in the third.
You know, I love it.
So the year before, you were them.
Yeah, and that motivated us, you know, like, for sure. Remember losing game six? It's the worst feeling in the world. Look at another team celebrate on your home ice, too.
Yeah.
I wonder what Mario's thinking, you know? Like
Mario, there's a video, you see his reaction. He's just jumping up and down with Natalie.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool to see that.
Ziggy.
Sick.
So many guys, hey? Like, those guys are big, too, day to day, hey?
Sure. We had a good crew around, the Black Aces, we call them, too. Like, even the younger guys.
They'd come in and tell us stories about going out the night before because we couldn't.
Yeah, because you guys were locked in.
Yeah.
They're your only lifeline to normal life.
Yeah.
We'll see the handshake lines, which you guys did the year before. This is crazy, right?
Yeah.
Your takeaway is that they feel, you think it looked like that they deserve better a little bit?
I think they were very confident in some way. We're like, they finished this game, they're like, what happened? The thing with the Detroit Red Wing is that we lost game 5-5 that year.
Yeah.
I don't think we could have beat them 5-0. You know what I mean? They were
totally
better. They were like a I don't even know if I can say that. They're a better team because we won, you know? So we're the better team. But they were more experienced. They won the previous year, very confident. They go get Osa, you know? So they've been there before. So for them, I really think it's like, what just happened? That's my feeling. For us, it's like we always believed in ourselves.
Yeah.
Way more than the previous year. Yeah. And we're like, we did it. We surprised them.
Because
we were underdog for sure.
You think in like 6 seconds they got a shot off?
Yeah.
So I always wondered about this too. Like, is there an idea like who gets it first, or you just automatically know?
I think there's like always a pecking order in a team. You know, you always
You know who's the older guys, and you know who deserves
it's like a tribe,
it. You know,
it's almost animal. You know,
but it's
like
planned. Instinctive. There's no planning on that.
No.
And even after too, like what you know, we ended up going to Mario Lemieux's house. You can't plan that.
Yeah, it just happens.
You know, hey, we're gonna cater a buffet just in case. TK, can we say that you're the guy that consume alcohol the fastest? Like, I remember, I think he was on the ice and he was already like, I'm like, TK, man, it's gonna be a long night.
Yeah. I'm a sprinter, not a marathon runner.
So Conn Smythe, Gino.
Yeah. And for me, as much as I have the reputation of liking the party and stuff, you know, I'm single and I remember like that night, I almost didn't drink. In a way where I didn't get. Yeah.
You didn't need to.
Just
flying.
I wanted to.
Next week.
I want to live this. You know, I want to remember stuff.
What were you guys saying to Gino here when he won the Conn Smythe? Or was just a blur? It's like, Gino, way to go, buddy. All right, let's go.
Yeah, that's it. You don't really care,
there's
right?
There's Talbot and Gino there. You gave him some love. He's loving it. Look at that. He's a beauty, man.
Gino is the best.
He's the best.
Even like going back to the room, like even the coaches like let off, you know, like they were drinking and like you don't never
see. Yozy was, I think Yozy, him and Yozy won like the contest.
Yozy went hard.
Oh, yeah.
Have you guys watched this whole thing, like the post game celebration up to the cup thing? Like seeing these shots and stuff?
No.
Wow.
What'd you think when they first brought it out?
I think I'm still in shell shock, you know, I'm like, you know.
And there it is. Amazing, hey guys?
Look at Dan Basel. He's like, yeah, I love it.
Almost broke my nose when I lift the cup. Like, I lift it, you'll probably see
it. And it kind of clunks down a little?
I give it a kiss, and I try to give a second kiss, and my nose is pretty big, and it got right the top of it.
It was a little heavier than I thought, though. Like, 35 pounds on skates is not, you're throwing it around. Like, it's a heavy trophy.
Yeah.
One kiss, let's see the nose bump. Oh!
I don't think he kissed it either. Like,
it really actually did hurt.
Oh, TK's waiting. TK's licking his chops.
I'm like, do I go in front of?
Yeah,
the order. Are you guys trying to rock, paper, scissors there, TK, or what?
Well, it's like, you know, the old.
There you go. You got it, bud.
Oh, no.
Come on.
NBC, figure
cut
it
to
out.
The, cut to the.
Figure
cut to the,
it out.
Cut to the Hoyt.
Yeah, split screen. Your celebration was great. Yeah. It was amazing.
You lifted it. Did you even touch it there? Did it even really happen, TK?
Yeah. I actually skated around the whole rink.
Okay, so we did it.
What a stressful game. Just to, even to watch. I'm
TK
just like,
needs a nap.
It was one of the best games of game seven ever, you know, because how close it was.
And you realize, too, like to me, you realize how it's a game of inches, details. You know, if, let's say, there's not a stick on puck at the right moment, or the puck doesn't just bounce, or that puck, the crossbar goes in, our life will be totally different.
You know, we won the cup. This is the best day of my life.
If you look at the butterfly effect of what happened there, and then ended up, you know, leaving the Pens to go to Philly because they thought I was a big game player because we win this cup. But if if we lose that game seven, even though I scored two goals, we don't talk about, you know, Stanley Cup champions. So everything that this game brought to our lives,
changes.
As it's been pretty special for sure.
To sit here and go through this with you guys and watch this is awesome.
Thank you.
I love playing with you guys. I love seeing that you guys got that opportunity. And of course, welcome back to Pittsburgh anytime.
The guy. And me and TK, now that we're here.
Yeah.
Anytime you're back, of course.
Thank you guys.
We're holding it down. But thank you guys for doing that. I really appreciate it. It was awesome.
Special.